So thanks to all of you to be part of this process. It was necessary and high time for us to come back again, though we had several other problems in the last few months. But this is called as very important as civil society to respond nationally to the crisis most vulnerable communities are facing today. As you know very well, as migrant laborers, most of them have left their own villages out of poverty in their own village, no employment in their own village, and nothing because of other disasters which occurred, and of course because of massive displacement in the region. Most of them were displaced and they have to move out for seeking a job. Now, this is the context of the past. Now, migrants are returning back home just because of the threat of the COVID virus. Now, from our understanding, what we have seen as we are in a difficult situation in terms of our participation as civil society, either in relief or in advocacy work at this juncture. Some of us as a team, we made a document over a period of 10 days involved, and we sent to all of you, as it called as informal and unorganized workers, a call for advocacy, which is very important for us. If you have seen the document in the last page, we have put as urgent action. It is not in order, but you can have an idea of what is needed now. The first one, we are facing the laborers who are walking on the roads towards their home. We don't know how to handle the situation. Police is involved. We can't even go and take care of them. We can't even quarantine them. And we had to get so many procedures before quarantining them. And many of them are taking different routes, avoiding the what I would call the catch of the police. So they have shortcuts walking and still on the move. We don't have any answer to that. But when you see the government order, it says nobody should walk on the road. It's very crazy to understand. None of the state governments, even very recently, have reacted of the people who have been walking. That's my first priority as a demand for all the states. Each state are blaming the other states. If you see the workers from Tamil Nadu belonging to Odisha, the Tamil Nadu government does not take the risk. And Odisha doesn't take the risk. And Odisha says, you walk down, you come to our border, then we will take care of you. Quite nonsense. And no voice. Neither the politicians or the opposition parties or even the corporations do not have a mind, not even having that human sensitivity to look into the kind of sufferings one has to go through and going through as children, women, and all the workers. What do we do with them is my first challenge. How do you tackle that? Should we still keep quiet and look at these incidents? Second, there are migrant workers who are not recognized as migrant workers, but still working in different parts of different states, within the state and outside the state. Because of these factories and small industries are locked down, they are quarantined themselves, and the employer is supposed to feed them. The employers don't give them the ration, nor the government gives the ration. The third one, we have a problem of holding the ration card or the other card for taking the rations locally with the government, which is not happening, which we have seen many cases like this. If you see other card, many of them don't have other card. Most of them are in these small industries or below 18. Some of them have manipulated their age in the other card just to get other card for the travel. And because they are saying 2021, really they are not 2021. They're 14, 15, 16 years. Now these people, most of them who don't have other card, they are in serious condition in the lockdown position, staying there. Now, immediately we had a message saying that trains are going to run, buses are going to take on, and some of the industries are going to open. Nonsense, nothing is going to happen. 90% of the people, migrant laborers, whether registered or not registered, they want to get back home. My challenge is how to work on this issue. Later on, we can take up labor issue, we get on children issue, health issue, yes, it's fine. But today, how the migrant laborers will go in safe, with security, with guarantee that each state, as interstates, takes the responsibility, which is a national issue. The next point is about the whole question of healthcare, where they are quarantined and there is no medical care at all going. Many of you have shared that. Many children are malnourished already. They're still going to get more malnourished. Pregnant women are there. If you take the other case of what we call the Brooklyn workers, not the company workers working in cotton mills, spinning mills, in industries, but Brooklyn workers, they are not workers, they are families. They moved out from their own villages as families, settled down in chambers and chambers, thousands and thousands of them. Nobody has a record, either in the state government or from their own state or in the state where they're working. They are migrant labor because women work, child work. Even during the lockdown period, the Brooklyn workers were working in the Brooklyn. They were not stopped and they were not given food. So these are my fundamental issues which we come across every day, and so many calls coming asking us, what do we do? When do we go? What are the procedures? Then suddenly portals came, Tamil Nadu portal, Orissa portal, that portal, everything has come in. People tried to log in and never worked. They are having, they logged in, but they don't know what to do. They got a message. But what did they do with the message? Where they go? Then the government said, we'll ask the panchayats to work. So every panchayat has given a format. The sarpanch went to the villages, collected the data. Some of them gave the data, some of them did not give the data. So even that data is not updated and shared openly for a policy for the government to respond with budget to see that they are transported back home. And our next challenge is insurance for all the migrant workers, whether it is lockdown period or post-lockdown period. Every individual have to be insured and taken care of. Even if they are traveling or not traveling, they have to be taken care of. And you will see very much the audacity and callousness of these government workers. I'm not telling that everybody are like that. At least few of the government officials are responding, but not all. Many of the politicians are dependent on the bureaucrats, what they decide. Even the politicians don't have any value. In the case of Orissa, the MLA don't have voice, the MP doesn't have voice. The bureaucrats rule the whole state there. So the panchayat sarpanch, what he will do? He can't do anything. Even MP is not heard, what a sarpanch will do? So we were calling for a rally called, what we have to do is physical distancing rally with all civil society, with all city people, the middle class people who are enjoyed the benefits of the exploited migrant laborers. They should be sensitized. They should come out in favor of the migrant laborers. We don't expect the corporation to come, the companies to come, the government to come, the middle class, the upper middle class, the poor. As civil society, we should do a physical distance rally all over the place so that further marginalization and discrimination doesn't push the poor to get more starved, hunger, and lead to death in the future. And as we see now, and this is what we are telling, why we have to call a meeting, not to collect the data, not to talk about analysis, not to talk about interpretation of research work, not to publish anything, but now what we do is important. So that is the challenge for us today. And only I will say this much, and we're looking forward that this as comes out as an advocacy group immediately, that a statement is coming out so that we can circulate a final statement as immediate needs where the government, the corporates should attend to. And this is my request to all of you, and I finish now. Please go through a document which we shared, and this is not that only one we are talking about an advocacy for this particular incident, but this group as an advocacy must continue in the future too for many other issues. Even in the case of minorities issues, in the case of children issues, in the case of women issues, the people are getting displaced issues, whatever you may say. And I recall back again initially what Walter said, how do we link understanding all of us to reverse our economic thought back home in the rural communities? How do you build an economy for people to live?